Hello, friends, and welcome back to Vintage Sports Shack, and welcome back to another episode of Don't Be Stupid. Today we're going to be talking about hobby boxes and are they rigged. So, as always, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, stand up, stretch out, because away we go. Okay, as always, guys, don't be stupid. Our hobby box is rigged. Of course they are. I know I've mentioned that I worked in a printing shop for 5-6 years off and on through college. We used to track every box, every carton, from front of the press to collator press to shipping. They know every box, every card, everything, where it's at, where it goes, where it's at in the shop. 30 years ago, we did it by hand. 35 years ago, it wasn't in a card shop, but we printed stuff for the government and important corporations where they had people in there, and they know where it's at. We used to talk to friends that worked at lottery ticket offices. It's the same way, or lottery ticket printing presses. They have individuals in there to watch it, to know every carton, every card, everything. Guarantee it. So don't be stupid. Now, when it comes to, is it a good idea for them to do it? A lot of guys on YouTube are saying, no. I say absolutely. It is an absolute fantastic idea for fanatics to do it, because 90% of the people that buy cards do not, and I repeat, do not watch YouTube videos. They have too much going on. Life, wife, children. They do watch YouTube. It's not me. It's Card Collector 2 or Sports Card Investor who is saying this is wonderful. It's guys like I talked about last week that are talking about investments, that even if you don't think they're good investments because they say so. So don't be stupid, guys. This is a hobby. This is something to do for fun. Fanatics has you guys all hooked like crack addicts. They know, even the people that watch, even if they get the good crack away, they got bad crack and semi-good crack. The crackheads are still going to try to get the semi-good crack, even if the good crack's gone, because it's going to be a little better than the bad crack. So they don't care. Same thing in cards. The 101, Jackie Robinson's gone. They don't care, because there's still some good cards. They might get that. They might get one of those 10 out of a million hobby boxes. They might get one of those 10. So don't be stupid, guys. Come on. Buy a hobby box, stick with the same card. Don't go from hobby box to football to baseball to this hobby to that card, chasing this next release to that release. Pick one. The only way these prices are going to come into line is when there's some regularity. There's so many new people into this that it just keeps over and over, new money. People get out of it because they realize it's a scam. Instead of coming into hobby knowing that it should be for fun. It's not about money. So don't be stupid. The boxes are rigged. It's good for the company. People don't care. So if we want to make things different, the people that do care need to step back, need to quit hustling people, need to quit taking advantage of the new people that come in, especially the dealers. Need to let them know, hey, that's already gone. Sorry. But as always, don't be stupid. Comment down below. Tell me what you think. always, peace. Have a super great day. And yes, keep dancing.
Smile from my face.